Hey, what is up to all my Secureteam fans? Probably wondering where has Tyler been for these past few days? Has he been kidnapped? No, I've just been working on Christmas decorations. You know, the same old stuff that you do. You gotta get ready for the holidays. And so I had to take a few days off. But I am back today with some very strange news that I want to feature to you guys. So let's just jump right into it. Things in space aren't always what they seem. And that is being well known and well received by the NASA flight crews that are from home managing one of our probes, one of our spacecraft that we shot off into space not that long ago to collect data off of some of these mysterious rocks that were found floating way out in space amongst the trajectories of Pluto and Jupiter and Saturn and things of that nature. We have many, many more strange objects out there. And so this probe that we're monitoring, it goes by the name of New Horizons. And according to these new reports here, something very weird is going on with New Horizons' next target, where just ahead of a January 1st rendezvous on the floating space rock that we had never seen before, they're getting these strange readings from the New Horizons spacecraft that suggest a mystery around the asteroid that they're monitoring and hoping to get up close to. So this space rock, it's acting very, very funny and suspicious, I guess you could say. Now, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft is probably the best known for the high-resolution photos of Pluto that it took back in 2015. But on January 1st, New Horizons will fly past an object even more distant than Pluto called Ultima Thule. And doing so, astronomers are preparing to learn more than ever before about these worlds lurking on the edge of our solar system. And according to new data from the spacecraft, they won't even have to wait until the next year to start, because this object, called Ultima Thule, appears not to have a light curve. And suffice it to say, when something doesn't have a light curve that they can detect, well, that sends these scientists into a bit of a perplexed spin, as it is nothing they have seen before. The New Horizons probe doesn't arrive to Ultima Thule for another week, but that doesn't mean that the spacecraft gets to just relax until then, no. The spacecraft has been busy taking photos and measurements of the asteroid and learn anything it possibly can about its destination before the big day. That can be challenging because even though the asteroid is so close, it still appears as nothing but a big, bright spot to the spacecraft's cameras. But still, that's not anything that should cause the scientists too much troubles, but here's where it gets strange. Usually, when they're flying up towards an object that is very bright, or has a very bright spot on it, or just encompasses a big bright spot, well, we have tools on board these spacecrafts that can still learn a great deal about that one bright spot by measuring what's known as a light curve. And asteroids such as Ultima Thule reflect sunlight, and that's why they are bright. But the amount of light that they reflect depends on how much of their surface is facing the sun. The bigger the area of the surface, the brighter they become. And while we know small asteroids like Ultima Thule aren't perfectly round, which means how much of their surface is facing the sun changes as they rotate, this means that over the days and weeks the New Horizons has been watching the small asteroid, it should have seen that the asteroid was getting periodically brighter or dimmer. And the information can then tell scientists about Ultima Thule's size, shape, and speed of rotation. But here's the kicker, guys. Ultima Thule isn't changing its brightness at all. And the New Horizons spacecraft has been watching this thing for going on 3 months now, and has not spotted a single change in brightness, which is really, really odd. Now again, Ultima Thule is definitely not spherical, and astronomers determined that a year ago, so why doesn't its brightness change? Well, there are a few possibilities that scientists have raised, but none of them are particularly compelling. It is possible that the New Horizons spacecraft has lined up with Ultima Thule's axis of rotation so that it's looking at the asteroid's north and south pole, and if this is true, it would explain the lack of brightness changes, but it would be one pretty big coincidence. So in a nutshell, just so you guys can get a better understanding of what's happening here, we have this spacecraft heading out there looking at various asteroids of different sizes, shapes, and some of these asteroids, they're not perfectly circular. They have strange shapes, and the way the light reflects off of those shapes gives these instruments aboard the spacecraft what they need to deduce things about these strange asteroids. And what they found was that this asteroid, again called Ultima Thule, does not seem to be changing its brightness at all, one bit. I mean, it's as if the thing is putting out its own light source. And whether it's spinning, whether it's moving up or down, whatever axis it's on, every time they try to snap a new picture of it and get closer, it looks exactly like the same bright, shiny light off in the distance, with scientists attempting to sift through the data and problems for the spacecraft, who can't seem to figure out why this thing is so bright, what's causing the brightness, and why are we seeing absolutely no dimming in said light that would allow the spacecraft to maybe map it out a little bit better and help us get a more rounded shape of what the object could look like. It's just very perplexing. So something very strange that they've never dealt with before is happening with this strange little asteroid, Ultima Thule. And so I wanted to put that out for you guys. We've done videos in the past of other so-called asteroids that depicted some very strange behavior, some of which were Comet 67P, which was a very strange and oddly shaped asteroid that not only had what appeared to many to be artificial-looking like structures strung across its surface, but it also seemed to have the ability to put out from within these magnetic oscillations that had been recorded by these space probes who were flying above it and picked up these strange magnetic waves coming out of the rock, a space rock, you know, a rock that should be dead, that should not be giving off any sort of magnetic waves at all, and yet it was. So Comet 67P, very, very strange. Now, other comets we've done stories on where they look like comets from afar or asteroids, and when we get up to them, we realize they are taking turns, they are doing maneuvers, and then they disappear. It's very strange to really know what's out there and if these things truly are asteroids or comets or just rogue rocks floating by. I think there's a lot out there they don't know, and this is yet another one that is causing issues with the space probes attempting to pull data from it, because everything about this new space rock rings totally false. They've never seen it before or dealt with it. Again, I will put the link to this down below. Popular Mechanics did a report on it. Something weird is going on with the New Horizons next target. And of course, the final question, is it going to turn out to be an asteroid at all? Well, time will tell. We got about a week to go. So with that, tell me what you think. And lastly today, in UFO World News, I'd like to show you guys a very interesting clip that was sent in by my friend and fellow YouTuber, Mr. MBB333. Now, while I do have a list of my own UFO sightings that I've got backlogged here and I am working on, but haven't gotten to the channel yet due to me sort of running around getting into the Christmas spirit and doing all of that stuff, I did want to feature this from Mr. MBB's channel because it truly is magnificent. We could very well have a catch of another one of these TR-3B black triangular crafts out there. And well, I'll give you guys a look. And afterwards, be sure to check out his page, subscribe to Secureteam, check out our online Secureteam merch. It is getting cold out there. And just stay tuned and check back, all right? Because I miss you guys, I love you all, and you can bet your bottom dollar that we will have some new Secureteam UFO-style videos up very soon. So stay tuned, stay safe, and enjoy this clip courtesy of Mr. MBB.
Saturday, December 22nd, 3 p.m. Mountain Time, 2018. Guys, in this video, we're going to take a look at a rare flying machine that was spotted over Toledo, Ohio. Right here is the exact location where this super rare flying machine, which you can see an insert right there, we're going to take a look at it much closer in this video. But here's the original clip of the man that filmed this. His name's Yukon. It's starting to come into view now. Apparently it had circled over his neighborhood two or three times. And he finally got a good look at it. And it looks like a perfect triangle, at least according to the configuration of the lights.
Dog, that is crazy.
He was very surprised. Now here's what we're going to do with the second half of the video. It's the same as the first. I've just slowed it down and we're going to zoom in and try to get a closer look at this thing, which I do. Can't look at it in any other format than what we see here. I've tried different filters and different techniques, and honestly, you can't see anything but the lights. But they do form a perfect triangle. Looks like it's possibly one of those TR-3Bs, but I don't know for sure. Definitely it's got a triangle shape to it. The light configuration kind of reminds me of the one I briefly saw for just a couple of seconds. Saw one like that about a year ago in triangle shape with those same kind of lights. Although the lights that I saw were more dull than that. Those are pretty bright. But it definitely looks like a triangle. Spotted over Toledo, Ohio by a man by the name of Yukon. Received the video within the last 48 hours. There's a good look at it there. I take some still shots from the video. We'll take a closer look. I'm here towards the end of the segment here. And again, there it's got 1, 2, 3, looks like maybe 5 lights, 6 lights possibly. One larger one in the center, a smaller one towards the front, 3 across the back, and then there's one right there. You can see it light up next to the 3 in the back.